Thank you for attending this presentation of the Snap Creator Framework. Today we're going to discuss the Snap Creator plugin for SnapManager for Microsoft SQL. Snap Creator has a packaged plugin for SnapManager for Microsoft SQL. This plugin is part of the Snap Creator install and is fully supported by NetApp. The plugin for SMSQL is a PowerShell-based plugin that simply calls SnapManager for SQL, using the same commands provided by SMSQL. Using this plugin requires that SMSQL is already installed and configured. A SnapCreator agent will need to be installed on the same host where SMSQL is installed. If SnapCreator requires SnapManager for SQL to be installed and running, then what's the benefit of adding SnapCreator into the mix? The SMSQL plugin allows for a central interface for multiple environments. If you're in a large environment with a large number of SMSQL environments, using SnapCreator will mean that you can schedule and monitor all of your SMSQL environments through SnapCreator, so you only need to work in a single interface. This still allows you all of the deep application integration provided to you by SnapManager. This isn't limited to just SMSQL. Most environments today have more than one database or application, and using SnapCreator will enable you to have a single interface for all of your standard and non-standard applications and databases. Let's take a look at how to set up a configuration with SnapManager for SQL in SnapCreator. I'm logged into the SnapCreator GUI. I'm going to create a new configuration file that will be used to back up the SnapManager for SQL environment. I'll create a new profile by clicking the Add Profile button. I'll name my new profile SMSQL and click OK. This will automatically launch the SnapCreator configuration wizard. Click Next. I'll start by naming my configuration file. Click Next. I'll select the application plugin type and click Next. Then I'll select the SnapManager for Microsoft SQL plugin and click Next. There are four parameters that I need to complete in order to set up the SMSQL plugin. As I fill out these parameters, I'm going to switch back and forth from the SnapCreator GUI to the host where SnapManager for SQL is installed, so that you can see where I'm getting the information from to complete the parameters listed. The first parameter is the PowerShell config path. As a reminder, if I hover over the field, I can get additional information on what this parameter is looking for. In this case, the example shown is the default path for the SnapManager for SQL install, and this is the same path I'll be using. But to verify this, I'll switch into the environment where SnapManager for SQL is installed. Windows Explorer is already open, and the smsqlshell.psc1 file is selected. Note the path. Returning to the SnapCreator GUI, I'll enter the path to and including the smsqlshell.psc1 file. Since the path includes spaces, I'll also encapsulate it in quotation marks. The Backup Options parameter details all of the backup settings for SMSQL to run. The SMSQL Installation and Administration Guide contains all of the commands, but there's an easier way. Returning to the environment where SnapManager for SQL is installed, I'll open the SMSQL interface. As mentioned, SMSQL needs to already be up and running correctly in order to use the SnapCreator plugin. You should have taken at least a backup of the SMSQL environment to verify that everything's working. Expand the hostname, then click Reports, and expand Backup. Select a backup report. I have the first one selected. Notice that at the very beginning of the log is a line that reads, command line syntax for this backup operation. After this line is the command that you'll need to paste into SnapCreator. The plugin automatically uses the new backup commandlet, so you don't need to include it in the command. Copy everything else in the line, starting after new backup. Return to the SnapCreator GUI, and paste this command into the backup options line. Depending on the settings of your SMSQL environment, your options may be different from mine. Add the SMSQL server name. If you look at the beginning of the command you just pasted, you should see the server name listed in the dash SVR option of the command. However, if you would like to verify this, return for your SnapManager for SQL environment, click on SnapManager for SQL Server, and you'll see this information listed under SQL Server Instance. Finally, select Yes to define that this is a 32-bit install of SMSQL, or No to define that's a 64-bit install. My environment's a 64-bit environment, so I'll choose No. Click Next. Enter your agent IP address or hostname, then click Next. Select your storage transport, then click Next, click Add. Add your storage system, as well as your username and password, then click Next. Select the volumes and move them from the left pane to the right pane by using the arrow keys in the center or dragging and dropping. My SMSQL environment uses the dbVol and logVol volumes. Even though the SMSQL environment will take care of doing the snapshot copies, you must still select at least one of the volumes. Make your selections and click Save. Add additional controllers or vServers if necessary, then click Next. Provide a snapshot copy name and a retention policy. SMSQL will actually take care of the snapshot names and retention, but Snap Creator still needs this info to complete the wizard. Enter the information, then click Next, and I'm going to click several times to complete the wizard. Then click Finish, and OK to complete the configuration file creation. Select your newly created configuration file. Click Actions, then Backup, and select your policy. Review the on-screen output. Snap Creator finished successfully. Once Snap Creator has completed, let's return to the MSSQL environment to verify that everything worked as expected. Click Refresh, and notice that the last backup time has been updated. That completes this presentation of SnapManager for SQL with Snap Creator. For additional information about Snap Creator, visit the Snap Creator Developers Community at www.snapcreator.com or visit the Snap Creator forum on NetApp Communities at www.netapp.com/snapcreator.